Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in this video we are going to see transistor logic family part 2. In this we are going to discuss two more types of a TTL. In first video we have discussed what is the working operation of a transistor logic as a NAND gate, but we have seen one drawback there, that is the fan out is not possible with that particular configuration. Now why is the question? That question we are going to solve in this video. So basically fan out is nothing but we have seen that one NAND gate can be drive a number of similar NAND gates, and that condition is known as a fan out condition. But in a totem pole configuration, or this is also called as a standard output configuration, in that fan out is not possible because we have a two transistors connected at the output side. So basically when it is a fan out, you are sourcing the current. So it decides the current sourcing capacity of that particular NAND gate. So whenever there is a transistor connected at the output side, the current sourcing capacity gets limited. Let's see how. So basically TTL can be classified based on the output configuration. The first one is an open collector where the fan out is a possible. Standard output or a totem pole, this is the configuration which we have studied in the previous video where the fan out is not possible. And the third one is a three state or a tri-state output where we get a different state of operations of the output of a TTL. So first see what is the drawback of a totem pole, then how this drawback can be overcome by using the open collector, and we will see how to utilize the three state or tri-state output NAND gate. So this is the similar diagram. Basically the first diagram you see, that is a totem pole configuration, or it is also called as a standard output configuration. Now this diagram, in this I have made a block which consists of a Q3 and diode. Now if you see, there is the output side, you have a transistor Q3 as well as a transistor Q4. Now if you want to add one more or number of NAND gate to the output side, if you are adding this at this particular terminal, now basically you are providing current. Since the Q3 is connected here, the current will be at this particular terminal will be controlled by the transistor Q3. Now the one criteria which we have discussed is that Q3 and Q4 both will not remain on at the same time, only either of them, one will remain on and the second one will be off. That means if Q3 is conducting, Q4 will be off. If Q4 is conducting, Q3 will be off. That means the current sourcing by the collector of a Q3 is undefined. And if you have an undefined current, then you cannot connect the number of NAND gates together. So basically this whole configuration is a NAND gate. And if you want, so this configuration is nothing but NAND gate. So if you want to connect more NAND gate to get the fan out condition, it is not possible because this current what you are getting is nothing but the current at the collector of a Q3, which is undefined. If it is undefined, you cannot decide how many gates can be connected, and this NAND gate, how many gate can be driven by the output of this NAND gate. So for that, this Q3 is removed along with the diode. That means this whole block, if you removed, your configuration will be look like this. Now this is the diagram for open collector. You can see if Q3, this part is removed, this transistor will remain as it is. So I have named this transistor as a transistor Q3. Now here the current at this, now this Q3 will be either off or it can be on, correct? So if it is on, the current will flow due to the VCC and resistance R3. And even if Q3 is off, then also the current flow through this branch will be the current because of the VCC and resistor R3. That means this current can be vary by changing the value of a resistor because it is no more depending on whether the Q3 is on or off. Previously, it was depend on the transistor Q because transistor was controlling the current, but here irrespective of the position of a transistor Q3, current can be controlled through by varying the resistance R3 and by varying the value of a voltage VCC that can be provided as a supply voltage. So this diagram can be shown. If you see, this is nothing but the, if you write down the name as a R3, that is a, this part, and this is Q3, then one more NAND gate can be added to this, R4, Q4, R5, Q5, and so on, Rn and Qn. So many NAND gates we can add together. So this is called as a wire ANDing, and this is what you are increasing the number of stages to the collector current. So the name is given as an open collector. If you open the collector, the current can be defined, and the number of NAND gate which can be driven by this single NAND gate can be defined properly. So the fan out is possible in an open collector. So the drawback of totem pole configuration can be overcome by using open collector. Then one more configuration we have, that is known as a tri-state. So here is the diagram for a tri-state. Here the only difference you can observe is the diagram is similar. Here you have a resistance R2 and R3. Only difference is that one terminal is used as a A, that is an input for the multi-emitter transistor, and the second input is connected to the diode whose anode is connected to the base of the transistor Q3, or you can say collector of the transistor Q2. Now how this diode will play a role, that we are going to see. So basically we have a different state. You can see in the chart we have an active state. In active state, either it will remain in a 1, that is the high state, or it will remain in a low state. The second one is a high impedance, and third one is also high impedance but provided by external input. We are going to see what is that external input is. So let's discuss the one case. So basically this is your one case, second case, and this two is called as a third case together, because this will give you the same operation where the output, you can see there is a no output is defined. So let's discuss the first, where the enable is equal to 1, that means this particular is equal to 1 and A is equal to 0. Since A is equal to 0, your Q1 emitter is at ground potential. If it is at a ground potential, the current will flow in this direction, correct? That means Q1 will be conducting. If current is flowing from VCC base to emitter, so it will also flow from collector to emitter, because the base collector will be reversed bias and base emitter will be forward bias. So my transistor Q1 will be on. If transistor Q1 is off, base of the collector transistor Q2 is not getting any input, so Q2 will remain off. If Q2 is off, it will split the phase in 1 and 0. Now if this is 1, so you can see Q3 will be turned on because the VCC will give you the current in this way, and Q4 is getting a 0, that means Q4 will remain off. So your output will be 1 because Q3 is conducting, diode will be forward bias. If diode is a forward bias, output will be 1. That is a first state, active, verified. Second case. In second case, enable is equal to 1 and A is equal to also 1. If both are equal to 1, then this base emitter junction will be reversed bias. If base emitter junction is reversed bias and base collector junction is a forward bias, current will flow in this direction, which will make Q1 is equal to off and Q2 will be turn on. If Q2 turn on, then it will split the phase in 0 and 1. So 0 is getting over here and 1 is getting to Q4. So my Q4 will be turn on and Q3 will be turned off. If Q3 is turned off, that means diode will be reversed bias. If diode is reversed bias, output will be 0. Again, verified. So here the output can either be 1 or it can be 0. So that means it is remaining on a one particular state, either high or low. So it is called as an active state because output should be either 1 or 0. The third case, where both the input are 0, 0, that means enable is also 0 and A is also equal to 0. Now when both the inputs are equal to 0, what will happen? This emitter is at a 0 potential. If it is at a 0 potential, again current will flow in this direction. Concentrate on blue ink. So my transistor Q1 will be turned on. If transistor Q1 is turned on, Q2 will be turned off. Now Q2 is turned off, till here the operation is normal. But You can see there is a diode. We will name this as a D, which is connected, the anode of a diode is connected to base of the Q3. And we have given enable is equal to 1. If enable is equal to 1, that means cathode of this particular diode, we will draw it separately, cathode and anode. So cathode is at 1 potential, that means diode is a reverse bias. That means at anode we have a 0 potential. So anode is connected to Q3, that means Q3 is getting 0. Similarly, if Q2 is off, we are getting 0 at Q4 also. That means Q3 will also remain off because of the diode connection at the enable input, and Q4 will also remain off because we are getting 0 because Q2 is not conducting. So both will remain in an off condition. But criteria says that the both transistors should not be at the same position. Either one of them should be on and one of them should be off. That means on, off, or you can say off or on. That is the proper situation of both the transistor. But if both are off, that means it is undefined state. So your output will be toggling. That means you will not get anything at the output because diode will remain off. Because this is also off and this is also off. So you cannot define whether it is a 1 or whether it is a 0. So that is called as a high impedance state, because at the output you are getting the high impedance. So it is called high impedance state. Now in next, enable is equal to 0 and A is equal to 1. Now since we have a 0 at this particular, this multi-emitter will remain at a ground potential. If emitter is at a ground potential, the current will again flow in this direction and in this direction. So Q1 will remain on. So Q1 is on. At the same time, if Q1 is conducting, Q2 is not getting any current. Q2 will also remain off and it will split the phase in 1 and 0. Now 0 is going to Q4. So Q4 is off. So accordingly, this 1, your Q3 should be turned on. But since diode is connected, so you will get 1 over here. So 1 is connected over here. Your Q3 should be on, but Q3 will remain off due to some reason, because the current will flow in this direction. So this is also called as a high impedance state, because you need an external input to turn Q3 is in a on state. So that is how these two output states are defined as a high impedance state. So it has a 3 states. One is an active state, the second one is a high impedance state, and the third one is a high impedance with the external input. So the name is given for this configuration is a tri-state or a 3-state TTL, that is a transistor logic. I hope you have understood the all three configurations. So let's see what are the applications and characteristics of the TTL. So TTL characteristics, first of all, power dissipation. Power dissipation is approximately 10 millivolt. As I said, it should be 0, but practically it should be low as possible. So it is in a milliwatt, so it's low. Propagation delay is approximately 10 nanosecond. Fan out with open collector is a possible. That means up to 10 NAND gate can be connected at the output port. Advantage is that TTL operation is a fast and less propagation delay, because the propagation delay we are getting 10 nanosecond, which is much more less. So that is a less propagation delay. So these are the advantages. So the application of TTL gate is whenever you want to perform a NAND gate operation with a logic families, you can go for a transistor logic family. I hope you have understood what is TTL family and how many types of configurations are there in a transistor logic family. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikeda. Do subscribe Ikeda. Thank you so much.